This is Samsung Mini Split Air Conditioner, and it is showing E101 error code on the display. And today I'll give you complete information about its error code. Now, this error could be related to the indoor unit or the outdoor unit. So, I will give you complete details about what kind of faults could occur in the indoor unit and what kind of faults could occur in the outdoor unit. First, I'll explain what could go wrong with the outdoor unit and what things need to be checked so that this E101 error can be cleared from the display and the unit can be brought back to working condition. If the outdoor PCB isn't working at all, this E101 error might still appear. Now, if the PCB is working and you see the light blinking, I'll explain how to check the outdoor PCB to confirm if it's indeed the E101 error being displayed. When checking the outdoor unit for faults, the first thing you need to check is the light. You see the green light here is blinking, which means the outdoor unit is functional and the switching components inside it are working perfectly fine. However, if the error still appears, I'll show you the other lights on the unit. When we come to the other side of the unit and you turn on the power, you'll see that the red light on the PCB turns on continuously. If it stays on, it indicates that the error is indeed the E101 error. This way, you can easily identify the error on the outdoor PCB. Now that I've removed the PCB from the unit, let me explain what could go wrong in the outdoor PCB that might cause this error code. Before repairing the PCB, you should always perform a physical inspection. In a physical inspection, you should visually check for any damaged parts, such as anything burned or blown up. This is a very easy way to quickly identify the issue and repair the PCB. If no physical damage is visible, the first thing you should check is the fuse. When you check the fuse, if it has continuity, it means something else is damaged. But if there's no continuity, the PCB might get fixed quickly by simply replacing the fuse. The next most common issue is the SMPS. When inspecting the SMPS circuit, take a look at the switching IC. Let me tell you the part number, TOP253PN. If this IC is damaged, it can cause problems. You should also check the resistors, diodes, and more importantly, the optocoupler, which often fails. Additionally, there's a reference IC installed in the SMPS that could also be faulty. The chopper transformer is another component that is likely to fail. Furthermore, if any of the capacitors short circuit, the PCB will not function and you will still get the E101 error. In this error code, there could be another issue related to the PTC sensor. If the PTC sensor has completely failed and is not functioning, the entire PCB won't switch on. When the PCB doesn't switch on, it will trigger the error code. So it's important to check the PTC sensor thoroughly, and if you replace it, there's a good chance the PCB will start working again. Additionally, this unit has a double IPM. If the PFC, power factor correction, booster fails, the PCB won't function, and you'll still get the E101 error. Another possible issue could be with the microcontroller itself. Furthermore, if the IPM becomes damaged, perhaps due to a short circuit, it could cause the PCB to be completely dead and non-functional. It's necessary to check all these components. Also, there's an overvoltage protection resistor, which often fails. If this resistor doesn't work properly, the unit could still show the E101 error. By checking all these parts in the outdoor unit, I'm confident that you'll be able to repair the unit completely. Let's talk about the serial communication circuit. You see, the serial communication wires are connected to the F1 and F2 terminals. If there's a fault in this area, it will also cause a problem, and the E101 error code will be displayed. If there's an issue with the wiring, you could also get this error. For example, if the wiring is reversed, like if you mistakenly connect the neutral wire with the line wire and vice versa, it can cause this issue. Or if you connect the wire from F2 on the indoor unit to F1 on the outdoor unit, this will also be incorrect and you'll get the error code. Any loose connections in this area can also lead to this problem. If the wires get burnt or disconnected, it will create issues and the error code may appear. So, you should thoroughly check these connections. You can check the continuity of the wires. Sometimes, even when the continuity is fine, the issue persists. In such cases, you should replace the entire wire and test the unit again. If the problem is resolved after changing the wire, it means the wires were faulty and you should install new ones. By checking and replacing the wires if needed, you can solve the issue and ensure the unit works perfectly again. Now, let me explain what faults could occur in the indoor unit. But before I talk about the possible indoor issues, let me clarify what this error code is. The E101 error in Samsung DC inverter air conditioners is referred to as a serial communication error. This error indicates a failure in the communication between the indoor and outdoor units. When it comes to the indoor PCB, what could possibly go wrong? Since the indoor PCB is working, the error will only appear when the PCB is functional. So, if the PCB is running but still showing the error, the most likely issue is within the communication circuit of the indoor PCB. If the communication circuit fails, it won't be able to communicate with the outdoor unit, leading to the E101 error. Therefore, you should inspect the communication circuit of the indoor PCB carefully. If the communication circuit is faulty, it needs to be repaired or replaced to restore proper communication between the indoor and outdoor units, which will ultimately clear the E101 error. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.